Hello guys and welcome back. As you can see, I finished placing all the yards. Here we have the rear mast with all the yards placed, the main mast, again everything is placed, and also the front mast, and of course the bow. So we have a very beautiful ship, as you can see, and yet I haven't placed any sail. So that's what we're going to do today. I'm going to place with you the sails of the bow, also the sail here, the vertical one, and one of the sails, probably for the sail of the main yard, because all the others are going to be exactly the same, but with different tying places. All the others will be exactly the same. Now, let me get ready, and I'll show you the first step you have to do before starting placing the sails. So guys, here as you can see, we have all the sails. They are ironed, and before proceeding to do anything, we have to identify them. Here we have the schematics, where you can see that each and every sail has a number. So we're going to use these numbers to identify the sails, because when I'm going to place them onto the model, I will only have the number, so I don't have to search at the time. It's better to do that now. Now, here we have a big sail. That's easy, I believe. It's this one. As you can see here, this is the one. So, this is the 420. I'm going to use some tape. I'm going to write the number onto it. So I'm going to do that for each and every sail, and I'll get back to you as soon as I'm done. Now guys, I'm ready. This is the first sail I'm going to place. It's the number 348. It goes, let me show you, it goes here. It's the big sail at the bow. And before placing it, let me explain something very crucial to you. Let's pretend that this is the yard, any yard. What we have to do is to stitch the sail over to the yard. We're going to use a specific way to stitch it, because if you try the normal way like this, then after a few stitches you will have the effect that the sail will be going all over the yard like this. You do not want that, believe me. What you want is the sail to be straight like this over the yard. So to do that, we're going to have to use a specific way of stitching. So let me get ready. Let me get my needle and adjust the camera, and I'll get back to you. Now guys, let's begin. First of all, you need to know that the length of the rope we're going to need is approximately 2 times the length of the yard. I always cut 2.5 or 3 according to the yard to be sure, because I want to have the extra rope, the extra thread, as you like, to be able to work with and not to be running out. Of course, if it happens to any of you to run out in the middle of the stitching, you can always tie it at the point that's end and start again. But no one will be able to see it, but it's easier to do it in one thread alone. So, first of all, here we have the sail. We see this specific sail doesn't have anything that goes underneath it at the moment, because some other sails might have. So we measure up, we see that the total length of the sail is almost a match to the total length of the yard. So we start at the very end. First of all, you make a double knot at the end of the rope. Let's see now. This is the outside. So I start on the inside of this edge. Always some glue to secure it. Now, the first thing you have to do, let me get something to be able to have the sail onto the yard, and I'll get back to you. Now, it's more easy to work. I don't believe you'll be able to see the stitch very clearly at this sail, but definitely you will be able to see it at the stern. Let me get this right and I'll see what I can do. So this will come from above. Always keep the sail to align in front of the yard and enter below at the same point where you made the first stitch. First step is done. Again, above, about 1 centimeter or 2 centimeters further. Be careful of these ropes here. You have to insert the stitch inside, not outside. You don't want to stitch this to the sails as well. Now, again, above, and you insert the thread through the previous stitch. After a few, will come together as it should be. Try to keep it stretched. Now let me see if I can move the camera and give you a different angle. Now let's do it again. Here, as you can see, I have made a mistake, so I'll have to correct it. I'm happy that I did that mistake, so you'll be able to see it. As you can see, this has caught this. I don't want to do that. Now, let's do it correct this time. Now, you continue to do the exact same thing all the way to the end. So, let me do that and I'll get back to you. Now, guys, as you can see, the sail is all stitched up. I will show you the stitches later. Now, I have to tie the sail. Before doing that, I need to place two pulleys. One on each corner, right here, and on the other corner. So, let me fix them, make them, to be more precise, and I'll meet you again to place them onto the sails and start placing the ropes. I have the pulleys. Now, to place them onto the sail, you make a small hole at the corner. And cutting off the excess rope. The same way, I'll do the other one and I'll get back to you. Now, let's pass the first rope. Let me see. This one must be tied approximately here. Here we have a pulley. You don't see it, it's underneath. This must go inside that pulley. And this must be tied over here. I'm not going to tie it there now because I have more ropes to pass through and these ropes will make the sail to look like this. So I'm going to tie it then so I'll be able to calculate how much to stretch it. For the time being, I don't want to have any loose ropes. I'm just going to lay it here, just like that. Not tying it, not securing it right now. So, let me do the other side as well, and I'll get back to you to continue. Now, guys, I have to pass two lines that are used to fold the sail. This is going to be tricky, but we'll manage to do it. First, I have to tie the rope approximately here. I have to pass it on the outside of the sail. It will come up from this side, inside this pulley. Inside this pulley, this is a double one, and over here to the rail, to be which is its final position. Also, I have to do exactly the same for this pulley. Again, tie a line on the outside, inside, through the pulley, through the double pulley, the other hole, and all the way here. So, I believe I'll start from the middle one. Now, let's calculate. This will go like this, inside here, over to that pulley, and all the way here. So let's cut it a little longer. And this one will end up, let me see, where, give me a moment. Now, this one will end up exactly at the center. This pillar here. Now, guys, again, because I don't like it to have too many ropes over here, I will tie it over to the rail. Now, I need to move the camera, guys, because I need the space, so let me tie this and I'll get back to you. Now, let's do the same for this one. So let me tie it properly, stretch this line, also tie the other side, and I'll get back to you with a finishing result. And this is it, guys. And let me explain something, because I made a small addition. According to the plans, this sail, too much for every sail, I believe, I'm on the ship, are folded up. I do not like folded up sails. I like them to be open, like this one. So, for this sail to be opened, I had to place two more pulleys here, one and the other side, and also attach them here and here, so that the sail will be stretched and not fooling around. So guys, this is the first sail of the bow. I also have to place another one, and I will move on to the stern. So I'm not saying that this video is done yet. I will place another sail at the bow, and I will be with you to place this sail at the stern. So give me some time to do that, and I'll get back to you. And now, guys, we are ready. I'm ready to place the vertical sail of the stern. The procedure is exactly the same as before. Here I have made a knot. I will secure it. So, it's done. You can see the stitches clearly. After I finished, I will show you the bow and the other side. Now, let me see how this sail is attached to everything else, and I'll get back to you. Now, guys, this sail is meant to be folded also, so I had to make a few additions to be able to tie it. I had to make a hole here. I will tie a line
here at the edge, go through the hole, down to this pulley that I just added, and it will be tied in one of these rings. Also, this edge will be tied to another ring right here. So, let me do that, and I'll get back to you. Now, guys, as you can see, I have tightened the sail through here, through the pulley, down here, and also this direct down here. Now, what I have to do is tie the upper half part of this sail with these three pulleys so that it can be folded down. That's not a hard thing to do. We start for the middle. The middle is right here. I will take the middle as this line, approximately at the half of this line. It has 14 lines, so approximately at the half here is the middle. So, approximately here, a small hole. Secure. Now this one must go through this pulley and down to the rail. So I need approximately this long. I don't want to stretch too much the rope because it's going to fold the sail and I don't want to fold it. This one, I should have passed it underneath, so I must redo this again. No problem, I will untie it and redo it. Not a hard thing. So, let me untie this and redo it, and then tie this down. And I'll get back to you. Here we are, guys. As you can see, all tied beautifully. Underneath, like it should be, all the way to the rail, and we have our sail. Also, we have a front sail, so let me show you the stitches. Focus, yeah. As you can see, these are the stitches that are made on the other side. Looks beautiful, and also we have the effect that we wanted to. We want this sail to be straight to the yard, and we have this effect. So guys, this concludes today's video. We only have one more video to make about the sales. I will place with you the main sail of the main yard of the big mast, and also I will place with you one of the vertical sails. I believe it goes right about here or here. Must be one or two here, a couple here, and probably one here. Don't remember exactly, but I will place one of them with you to show you how it's done. All the other sails are exactly the same or similar to the four that I placed, to the two I placed now and the two that I will place with you in the next video. And then it will conclude the building of this model, because the next video after the video of the sails will be the last one, will be the making of, will be in 4K, and you can witness the build after 8 and something months to come to an end to a beautiful ship. So, thank you again for watching, guys, and staying with me. I will see you soon with the next video of placing two more sails.